Once upon a time, in a faraway land, there lived a young man named Till Eulenspiegel. The rising theme represents Till's youthful optimism, which we will call Till the Adventurer. The 7-beat theme doesn't fit well into the 6/8 meter, so Till takes 3 tries to gain his balance. First, he tries to start on the 2nd beat, then the 3rd, and off he goes. Till isn't just a young adventurer, he's also a prankster. Listen again to the descending clarinet theme. These 2 themes form the basis of the entire work. Strauss integrates this Till the Prankster theme first into the violins, then horns. As Strauss wrote to the conductor of the premiere, Franz Willner, "It seems sufficient to point out the 2 Eulenspiegel motifs, which in the most manifold disguises, moods and situations pervade. For the rest of the story, let the citizens of Cologne guess at the musical joke that the rogue has offered them." Though we don't know the exact story that was running through Strauss's head, thanks to some notes in his score, we have a good idea. The chaos swirls away as he rides out of the village. You can almost hear Till planning his next move, laughing to himself about the whole affair. Emboldened by his first prank, Till dresses as a priest, preaching earnestness and morals to the townsfolk, while pocketing the offerings. The bases, however, betray his pious facade. Till's pathetic pleas of empathy are met by muted trumpets and horns. They foreshadow the judgment to come. But Till pays no attention. Seeing some beautiful women off in the distance, Till decides to dress as a Don Juan and flirt with the young girls, dancing to his soaring love theme. You can hear that the theme is nothing more than our Till the Adventurer theme. But sadly, the women are not interested. Bittered by his rejection, Till's critics take the opportunity to mock him. Strauss liked to include his musical critics into his tone poems, most notably in Ein Heldenleben. They relentlessly hounded him his entire life, saying of this work, "That the music fascinates is true, but it is in part an awful fascination, void of aesthetic charm." A horrible example of what can be done with an orchestra by a determined and deadly decadent. Casting off his previous failures, Till escapes to the village. Gaining confidence, he struts about and we again hear Till the Adventurer. Soon noticed by the guards, and the chase ensues. Thank you. Thus concludes the tale of Till Eulenspiegel and his merry pranks. Some say his spirit ascended to heaven, while others swear they see him hiding in the hills, waiting for his next prank.